But the one thing I cannot stand is when... Hi guys, welcome back to another video, and today's topic has been one of the most requested by you on my Instagram, and that is if food can cure Crohn's disease. So make sure you keep watching as I will reveal all to you the answer, but before we get started, make sure you hit that subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up. Just a little reminder, you can also find the links to all my social media, so my Instagram, Facebook and Twitter, in the description below, as well as the link to my website where you can sign up to my newsletter for more exclusive content. In order to know if food can cure Crohn's disease, we have to first understand how Crohn's disease affects your gut or digestive tract. So, Crohn's, as you may know, is one of the two main forms of inflammatory bowel disease, and it can occur anywhere along your digestive tract, which runs from your mouth to your anus. Each part of your digestive tract plays a role in digestion, but the small intestines is where the majority of your nutrients are absorbed. And if Crohn's disease affects your small intestines, then this can cause interference in how our bodies actually absorb and are able to digest food. Your small intestines are split into three parts: the duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. Crohn's disease that affects your duodenum, which is attached to your stomach, and it's the first portion of your small intestine, is known as gastroduodenal Crohn's disease. If the second portion and third portion, your jejunum and ileum of your small intestine, has Crohn's disease, this is known as small bowel Crohn's disease. Now, the last portion of your small intestine, which is called the ileum, and the junction where your small intestine meets the large intestine, is known as the ileocecal junction, and Crohn's can affect this area, and this is sometimes referred to as terminal ileal and ileocecal Crohn's. As mentioned, the small intestines is where most of what we eat is digested, but having areas that are affected by Crohn's may cause some of the food to be undigested, and this can bring about some of the symptoms we experience, such as pain and diarrhea. Now, this undigested food will enter the large intestine, where we have so many different types of bacteria that will ferment this food, and a byproduct of this fermentation is gas. And if you don't know where I'm going, that is how we experience bloating and the discomfort experienced with bloating. There is no doubt that Crohn's can impact our nutrition, and so a lot of people end up changing their diets to try and cope with Crohn's. But the one thing I cannot stand is when companies or fad diets DM me on Instagram saying that they can cure my Crohn's disease. Please do not believe all these people that say that by going on a certain diet or going on a magic nutritional pill has cured their Crohn's disease. It's just a money-making scheme. Yes, they may be symptom-free, and I'm not going to argue if that's what they've bought into, which has helped them in experiencing less symptoms, but they are not cured, they are just in remission. The difference is that a cure implicates the disease is gone forever, but with Crohn's, the disease or the diseased part of the intestines, they are still there. It's just that your Crohn's is inactive or has gone to sleep. So unfortunately, diet alone cannot cure Crohn's disease, because nutrition is not a one-size-fits-all. What works for me may not work for someone else, and vice versa. However, some people, myself included, have found that their symptoms are reduced by making certain diet changes. Now, before changing your diets, it's really important to actually discuss this with your doctor and then get referred to a dietitian who is qualified to ensure that you get the correct balance you need, which is what I have done, and all my sort of nutritional needs have been taken care of. But the one thing that can be said for certain is that there is no cure for Crohn's disease, and even though food cannot cure it, making dietary changes that are specific to you and that work for you can certainly help manage your symptoms. So that brings me to the end of this very short video, and if you have any thoughts on what I've just said, or if you know what your trigger food is, then let's start a discussion in the comments section below. And if you haven't already, please give this video a like and hit that subscribe button, and I will see you next time for the next video.